Subscribers and friends, welcome to Wayne's RC. Well, got an unboxing of the Eflite Folk Wolf FW-190. Oh, let's get it out of the box and see what we got. As soon as this plane came out, I wanted it. I've got a Hobby King Folk Wolf, but I saw everything that this plane had. All the scale detail and smart technology, so I had to have it. And it is a big box. Get it out of here. Knocking anything over. Okay. To get my little table out here. Excuse me a second. Very nicely packed. Could have been a little more organized. It was kind of a last minute thing. A little busy lately. Okay. Here's the wing that snaps in. Plastic, no step signs here on the aileron. Real nice hinges. Very nice. There's some thumbprints on there. I don't know what that's all about, but. Middle part of the wing retracts. Wow, huge. And looks like what this has that the P-51 1500 millimeter has it. That didn't is the plastic support for the gear on the P-51. The foam would crack above the landing gear, so I think this is going to be a big improvement on that. I don't think you'll see that cracking on the foam. Okay, here's where the wing ends go in. Nice scale, detailed scoops. Here's a place where the bomb or fuel tank, I think it's a fuel tank, goes. Nice. Okay, get the other half of the box off. cut the tape here. And here's where most of the plane is. Have the thumbprints. I don't know if they were testing it at the factory. Make sure it clicked into the wing. But I guess it's no big deal. We're gonna get thumbprints on it. And this one plane has the plastic around the edge where the wing, outer wing attaches to the inner part that the P-51 didn't. So that's nice. That's another improvement. Okay, the bomb or tank slides right. Well, that's easy. I like that. I might even put that on for a flight or two. We'll see. Okay, here's the horizontal stabilizer. Okay, more no step plastic, little plastic bit here. These are foam hinges. They're laminated, but yeah, they're laminated. Okay. Little bits and pieces. Guns, torpedo tube, screws for the wing and horizontal stabilizer and prop. Three blade. And it's part of the hub that's got that fan. Cools the ESC. And I guess from what some guys were saying, it sounds really cool. So that's kind of unique. I don't know if the full-scale plane had that. Maybe. And here's the spinner. I like that painted like a Twilight Zone thing. That's cool. And the manual. And last but not least, well, the carbon spar here. Never mind. It's for the horizontal stabilizer. And think I'll put down my shop blanket for the fuselage here. And here she goes. Always the best part of the plane. Wow, that is nice. Super nice. Big old beefy motor. Pretty darn sharp. Nice rivets. Nice decaling. Everything on there. Really nice, no bubbles. Got a little light on the back, the rudder. The old tail wheel. Super nice. Super nice. Now let's get into the canopy here. Watching some of the other reviews, and you're pointing out about the plastic around the battery hatch canopy. Yep, that'll be nice. That's a part of the plane that always gets dinged and scratched, and they got plastic all the way around. Yeah. Yeah, that's nice. And we got the ER-637T. Whoop. Right here. Hopefully you can see that. I can't really get around the box and the foam packing is in the way. And of course you got your IC5. And then your battery tray slides. Same as the P51. Oops. Looks like the same as the P51, the quick connects. Sharp. Okay, that's it. Get this thing together and tell you if I had any issues. I don't expect there will be any, and pretty easy build. Very easy build, as a matter of fact. So that won't take any time. See if I can get the hatch back on here. Okay. Tongue in there. Okay. It's the unboxing of the Eflite FW-190. Like and subscribe. And thanks for watching. Have a good night.